Almost late, but not late. Bonjour à tous. We'll do as always a sound check. Can you tell me if the sound is okay? Here it is. Salut. Got a first student here. How is everyone? Is everyone very motivated and ready for a special live stream today on verbes pronominaux? Salut Mauro. Super, tant mieux. Donc le son, c'est bon. La leçon du jour, les verbes pronominaux. I write that right now. Alors, je pense que le live du jour, c'est A2, B1. Maybe. But of course, everyone is more than welcome. It's just that I'd rather let you know. Les verbes pronominaux. Mm-hmm. They can be divided in at least two families. Hello, Mary. Comment ça va? It's been a long time. Feels like it's been a long time, but it was probably just 2 weeks, as always. Let me get ready for les verbes pronominaux. It's a quite straightforward live stream we're going to have today, like very clear steps, let's say, that I would like to explain to you. So first, I would like to divide them because verbes pronominaux, okay, let's warm up. If I tell you verbe pronominal, what would you say spontaneously? What's coming out of your mind? I miss you too. It's my good time of the week, every other week, with a latte. Mm-hmm. So if we think verbe pronominal, verbe pronominaux if we speak in plural, what's on your mind? Qu'est-ce que vous diriez? You take your time. You give me at least 5 or 6 verbes pronominaux. And from that, I would like to explain to you that we have like 2 big families of verbes pronominaux and why it is important to understand how they work. Yeah? Delicious. Yeah. That's why I was 45 seconds late. It's just finishing to warm up my latte. Mary, give me des verbes pronominaux, and Mauro too. I would like you to give me at least 2 or 3, 2 ou 3 verbes pronominaux que vous connaissez. Comment? That's the first super easy question of this live. We have some more people here, so of course everyone can participate. I was just like picking Mary and Mauro because I know they're here. Voilà. Merci. Très bien. So, Mary, you actually gave 3 verbs that are part of the same family of the pronominals. Ils sont tous réfléchis. D'accord? Ils sont tous réfléchis. That means, bonjour, bonjour, bonjour. Ramadan Moubarak, bien évidemment, à vous. Se lever, se doucher, s'habiller. These are all actions that I do upon myself. I don't know if I can say that in English. Do you understand? Non? Ce sont des actions que je fais. Voilà, c'est ça. C'est bien dit, Mauro. J'aime bien. Oui, ce sont des verbes. Donc, how did you say that? Des actions tombent sur le sujet. Yeah, kind of. C'est moi. C'est moi qui me suis levée. C'est moi qui me suis douchée. Et c'est moi qui me suis habillée. So in that case, on est dans la famille des, with the verb she gave, Mary gave. On est dans les pronoms, dans les verbes pronominaux réfléchis. We call them this way, non? But there's another family. All the one you gave, Mary. Réfléchis. Oh, it's taking some time to be sent. Here we go. D'accord. Mais il y a également les verbes pronominaux réciproques. Réciproques. Ah, we have another one here. Absolument. Se coiffer. Donc là, c'est vraiment une action que je fais sur moi-même. On est toujours sur un verbe pronominal réfléchi. Mm-hmm. L'action, as Mauro said, I like the idea, tombe sur moi. But it's true. C'est une action que je fais sur moi-même. D'accord ? Donc, toutes ces actions du quotidien, se lever, se doucher, se brosser les dents, se... OK ? Here, for example, this doesn't work for several reasons. The first one is that we don't have what we call le pronom réfléchi. If you really wanted to use this sentence as a verb that is pronominal, you would say, je me suis nagé ce matin, which is not really possible. You would just say, j'ai nagé ce matin, I swam this morning. Nager n'est pas un verbe pronominal, ni réfléchi, ni réciproque in that case. It's still an interesting sentence, but you would say, j'ai nagé ce matin, I swam this morning. Yeah? OK. OK. Se coiffer, so, se coiffer. Se brosser les dents, absolutely, which is part of the verbs from your daily routine and these actions that you do to yourself. OK? Now, ça c'était pour les verbes réfléchis. I can see that you know, yeah, une action quotidienne, absolument. Une action quotidienne, kind of self-care, also. Things you do to yourself. I think this is clear to all of you because you gave me quite a lot of verbs of that kind. Now, if I ask you des verbes pronominaux but réciproques, if you know the word réciproque, maybe it helps. You'll be like, okay, réciproque, let's see. I wish I had the stress on top of réciproque. Please forgive. Réciproque. Sorry. I really, 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 really have to buy a French keyboard. This is not working anymore. Mm-mm. Anyway, verbe réciproque. Would you give it a try? Would you try to give me un verbe pronominal réciproque? I'm sure once I give you one, you'll be like, ah, yes, now I know. Can you see a lot of the... Yeah, you can see a lot of the mess behind me. Let's see if I can hide a bit. There we go. There we go. Le setting est parfait. Alors. Vous parlez un peu français, s'il vous plaît. Vous voulez dire que tu es fatigué de m'entendre parler en anglais? Tu veux only French? I don't do only French for one reason. Le sujet du jour, c'est les verbes pronominaux. And I really want you to understand like the technical parts des verbes pronominaux. Alors, les verbes sont bien évidemment en français, les exemples en français, vos questions en français et mes réponses, sometimes half-half. Please don't be angry. It's just to make sure tout le monde comprend. Yeah? Okay, cool. Ben voilà! Voilà, se téléphoner. Excellent. Réciproque. Réciproque. You know that sometimes on ajoute... avec téléphoner, it would be super unnatural. But you say sometimes, ils se sont l'un l'autre. For example, with the verb encourager, s'encourager, ils se sont encouragés l'un l'autre. To insist on the fact that it's mutual. Réciproque, one another, très important. Donc là, on est toujours sur un verbe pronominal, mais l'objectif n'est pas le même. Se téléphoner, donc c'est très bien, ils se sont téléphonés l'un l'autre, somehow, d'accord? You wouldn't say, je me suis téléphoné. Pas beaucoup de sens. Donc ça, c'est la deuxième chose qui est très, très importante. If you're like, je ne sais pas du tout comment reconnaître un verbe pronominal réfléchi et un verbe pronominal réciproque. I tell you, there's one tip. Your subject will be plural. le sujet sera pluriel. Pour insister on the fact that it's a mutual action. Yeah? Donc, ils se sont téléphonés. Nous nous sommes téléphonés. Vous vous téléphonez chaque semaine. But with je and tu, and actually il in singular, it doesn't make sense. That's when you know, ah, ok, là, je suis sur un verbe pronominal qui est réfléchi. Mm-hmm. On a beaucoup plus d'exemples. Hein. Donc, se téléphoner, ça marche très bien. It's a classic. Ils s'aiment toujours. Excellent exemple. Ça, c'est pareil. Hein. C'est un grand classique. Bien sûr, on peut dire qu'on s'aime soi-même. But in that case, you see, you have a plural thing. So, on comprend qu'ils s'aiment l'un l'autre toujours. D'accord ? Vous parlez français, je parle français. And Mary explained that she was actually here, se rencontrer, se saluer. Voilà, très bien, très bien. I really have to do this video again, the lesson about like reflexive verbs and everything, because I think some of my explanation may have been a bit, I don't know. I think now I could really make it a bit clearer on something, so I'll do another lesson on that. Ils se sont regardés mutuellement, bien évidemment, d'accord. Alors ça c'est pas mal, ça c'est pas mal. Non, c'est très bien même. Je me réveille à 7 heures. Là, on est donc avec le je sur un verbe pronominal réfléchi et pas mutuel, d'accord. Se préparer, action sur moi-même, same thing. Je me suis trompée, however. That probably comes in the third family, because je me suis trompée. It's kind of these verbs that are pronominal by nature. Because it's not really that you know what it means, non? Je me suis trompée, it's like I made a mistake. The fact that it's pronominal is a bit weird. Je me suis trompée? J'ai trompé moi-même? No, that's not what it means. You made a mistake. And these verbs, like this kind, I have a full list of them. Some of them, of course, are just pronominal because they're pronominal, by nature, as we say, par essence. Oh my God, wait a second, no battery left. I was working in another spot, so I forgot the, really sorry, hopefully I can make it. That would be a mess. Here we are, tout va bien, tout est sous contrôle, sorry. Je disais donc, je me suis trompée, it's probably part of the verb that are pronominal par essence, par nature. We'll talk about them a bit later. It's a very good example. It's a very good example. Je me couche, yes. So this one, yes, it's definitely un... Alors voilà, là, tu as pris deux exemples différents. Je me couche, c'est le verbe pronominal réfléchi, et vous téléphonez chaque semaine, celui-là, c'est le verbe pronominal réciproque. Yeah? Okay. This is like an imperative. There is no real, except if you're telling me that I have to wash my hands, but otherwise, you would say, je me lave les mains. Yeah? Je me lave les mains, ou tu te laves les mains, which is also un pronominal. Réfléchis. C'est une action qui porte sur toi-même. Je me suis réveillée. Très bien. Très bien. So this is very good. Yeah. Okay, let's see if I had some more. Some that we don't, because yeah, we have all these that you've just said, like that are like kind of this action we do on ourselves. There is also the s'habiller with, se demander. I wrote this one, se demander, like to ask yourself something. Je me demande où ils sont. Je me demande où j'ai laissé mes lunettes. C'est un pronominal réfléchi. Et pas du tout réciproque. In that case, je me demande à moi-même. And it's not something like really an action. It is, but in a more like abstract way. Je me demande où j'ai laissé mes lunettes. Yeah. Ah, yeah. What I wanted to see with you, just the pure grammatical thing. When you say tu, sorry. For example, tu te lèves tôt tous les matins. Tu te lèves tôt tous les matins. Just so you know, you would say, can't believe it, I don't have the, this is so annoying. tu te lèves. Lève, of course, there is the one you put here. Okay, I'll correct that. Tu te lèves tôt tous les matins. There are two mistakes in my own sentence. Lève et tôt, of course, avec l'accent circonflexe. Très important. Tu te lèves tôt tous les matins. It's important to know that, grammatically speaking, tu est votre pronom personnel. Je, tu, il, elle, on, nous, vous, il. D'accord? C'est un verbe réfléchi. Oui. Oui, oui, bien sûr. C'est un verbe réfléchi, se laver les mains. Yeah, yeah, you wash your own hands. Tu te lèves tôt tous les matins. Pronom personnel. Pronom réfléchi, c'est le te. Je, me, tu, te, il, se, nous, nous. This is the pronom réfléchi. Et ensuite, le verbe. This is just good to know. Like, if your teacher says, oh, your sentence is good, but your pronom réfléchi is missing, at least you know what it is. It's this me, se, nous. Okay? Yeah, and of course, what happened to these verbs au passé composé? So these are the first two big families. Yeah? Les réfléchis, les réciproques. Looks like you don't have much problem with that. You understood the whole thing. Pour réciproque, just so you know, I put a little list of s'aimer that we had before. You said it. Se disputer. Maybe we can have a couple of sentences with the verbs I will give you. Let's see. So we check if you know them all. Can you make a sentence in passé composé? Because it's funnier. Avec se disputer. Oh, yeah. And then I have another big question for you. A big grammar question. Let's see how you feel about it. Donc, une petite phrase avec se disputer. Bonjour à tous. Se dire, alors ok, if you have some other, that's fine. I don't know if you asked the one I was asking for, se disputer. But if you want to make a sentence with the verb se dire, which can, it can be actually pronominal verb, you can try an example. Nous nous sommes pratiqués le français aujourd'hui. Maybe we can correct this sentence. I need someone to correct this sentence. It's a good try, very good try. But it would be nice to correct this sentence. And this one. Thank you very much. Because you're the first one to try something with this verb. Nous nous avons discuté. Ah, I said disputer. Se disputer. Because actually, discuter is not pronominal. No, discuter is just like to discuss something. Mais se disputer means something else. Yeah, so let's try. Okay, I will correct this one. That's good. Thanks, Mary. Okay. Je me suis disputé. Avec mon frère. But basically, really, I had an argument. Yeah, I had a fight. Not physical fight, of course. Just like I had a fight. Je me suis disputé avec mon frère. Remember that the possessive depends on what follows. Frère is masculine, so it's mon frère. It's not like in English. Yeah, it's mon frère because you say le frère. Je me suis disputé avec mon frère. Elles se sont disputées pour cette robe ou à cause de cette robe. Elles se sont disputées, ES, maybe, Mary, because it's like plural, but it's also feminine. Elles se sont disputées pour, à cause, au sujet de cette robe. Yeah? Je me suis disputée avec mon frère. C'est bien. Nous nous sommes disputés, ils se sont disputés. Always including more than one person. Yeah? Because it's something that's happening like that. Ce sourire. Can you give me an example with the verb ce sourire? Ah, you see, I have the same. Yeah, exactly. Absolutely. Yeah. Qui? Elle s'est disputée. Careful with the writing, the spelling. Disputée avec, same thing as above, son mari. Husband is masculine, you say le mari. So when you switch to possessive form, you say mon mari. Ma mari is not possible. Yeah, in French, what matters is what you're completing. Bonjour. C'est bien. Ce sourire, c'est un petit peu... voilà, elles se sont disputées à cause de cette robe. Super. Très bien. Très bien, très bien. OK. Ce sourire, c'est un petit peu comme l'exemple de Mauro avec se regarder, to look at each other, or to smile at each, in that case, it's to smile at each other. Ce sourire, can you make a sentence with ce sourire? Yeah, je me suis baignée, careful. Baignée cannot stay in infinitive. Baignée will have to be written with an accent, a stress on top of the E. Je me suis baignée, one E, if it's masculine, and double E, if it's a girl speaking. Alors, je me suis disputée avec ma mère. Ah, OK, I know what you mean. Basically, because you woke up late, no? Something like that. Je me suis disputée avec ma mère. Wow, this is very... we would never say that in French. Like, concernant le temps. First, it's not le temps. It's l'heure. L'heure. L'heure à laquelle je me suis réveillée. But that's a bit weird. You would say, je me suis disputée avec ma mère, and then maybe parce que je me suis levée trop tard, or something like that. That would sound a bit more natural. I would like someone to correct this sentence. Guys, we are about 15, which is really not much. Where are the people? 15 people here, so I'm sure someone can correct that. Ah, elle se sourit quand elle est regardée le film. Non. I cannot agree with this one. I cannot accept this sentence. So I need someone to correct this sentence. It's a good try, but it's not working. And this one. And then I have a very big and important grammar question. Kind of B1 question. So let's see how you feel about it. Quelqu'un peut corriger. Donc, j'aimerais qu'on corrige cette phrase et cette phrase. I need two teachers. Nous nous sommes souris. C'est bien. C'est bien. Et est-ce que, Mauro, est-ce que tu sais pourquoi, spontanément, tu n'as pas mis de S à la fin de souris? Is there a reason or is it like, oh no, now that I'm thinking about it, I actually would have put a final S. Est-ce qu'il y a une raison pour laquelle tu n'as pas mis de S? Because look, for example, Lenny, he wrote, nous nous sommes souris. And I guess his logic is that because it's être, probably we need to put a final S. You didn't. Why? So that's the kind of who's right here and why. Nous nous sommes souris, S. Nous nous sommes souris, I. Elle sait souris is very weird. Like, it could be if she's looking at her in the mirror that she kind of smiled at herself. But the idea was that it was something mutual. Nous nous sommes souris. You smile at me, I smile at you. Ils se sont souris. One another. Yeah? This one doesn't work. Because it's not, well, it doesn't work. Just, it's not discuter, but it's disputer with a P. It's very interesting, actually, to see the difference between discuter, which is, I told you before, to discuss, to talk about something, and it's not pronominal. Discuter, that's it. But se disputer, to have an argument over something or to, yeah, to argue, to fight. Mm-hmm. I don't think you have the answer for the nous nous sommes souris. Maybe I just ask my question. Like, my question was, why do we write this? D'accord, Mary. Les souris se sont souris quand elles ont trouvé le fromage. Is that like you invented this one or you found it somewhere? So Mary, be careful. Yeah, no, but wait, we'll see why. Ah, Mauro is here. Sorry, I'm rushing you, but indeed, il y a quelque chose par rapport au complément d'objet direct or complément d'objet indirect. Let's see if we can clarify this. It's actually quite interesting. Well, it's again like a very nice French rule to complicate our life, but let's see. Why do I have to say and write this, but that's the big question. Why? Why elles se sont rencontrées, ES, but elles se sont téléphonées et... Confusing. Why? What's the rule behind it? Because luckily we have a rule. It's not like it's just happening. No, I can explain. And Mauro, you get the answer, like 60%. But can you... Est-ce que tu peux développer or do you need help? Okay. Le COD est avant le verbe. C'est des bonnes tentatives, hein? It's some good tries, but actually it's because you would say Rencontrer quelqu'un. Without any preposition. Rencontrer qui, quelqu'un ou quelque chose. That's a bit weird. Rencontrer quelqu'un. Donc, effectivement, complément d'objet direct. However, vous téléphonez à quelqu'un. Vous téléphonez. Voilà, 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 voilà. Qui n'ont jamais un COD. Kind of. Yeah. Ils n'ont pas de COD parce qu'ils sont indirects. Ils ont une préposition. Exactly, Mauro. That's it. That's the one. So, dans l'exemple que j'ai donné, elles se sont rencontrées because you say rencontrer quelqu'un and not rencontrer à quelqu'un ou rencontrer de quelqu'un ou rencontrer pour quelqu'un. It's not always à. Hein? But elles se sont rencontrées, ES, in that case. However, vous téléphonez à quelqu'un. And that's why there is no, il n'y a pas d'accord. I can't even say that in English. Il n'y a pas l'accord. L'accord masculin, féminin. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. So we've got it more or less. I think we can have quite a few more examples. J'étais donc avec ce sourire. Sourire à quelqu'un. Yeah. Et pas sourire quelqu'un. That's why what Mauro said was actually very good. I can't remember. Elles se sont souris, non? Or something like that? With I. And that's correct. And your question, Mary, when you were like, souris, ES, not too sure, was also a very good question. No, in that case, souris will stay souris. Because we have this preposition, normally. It's sourire à quelqu'un. Mm-hmm. J'ai dit se rencontrer. Se comprendre. Yeah, why not? Can we have a sentence with se comprendre de manière réciproque? It can be in present or in passé composé. It doesn't matter, but just an example with the phrase like se comprendre. Nous nous sommes souris. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. C'est ça. C'est ça, c'est ça. Je me suis comprends. This is interesting because it's a bit of a review of the past participle. How is it? Je me suis, which is weird because you're actually not putting this verb in réciproque, but in réfléchi. It's interesting, but it would be je me suis compris. And if I'm talking to myself, I would say je me suis comprise. Yeah. Nous nous sommes souris. Final I. And that's it, un i final, et c'est tout. Elles se comprennent bien, absolument. Elles se comprennent bien. Ils se sont compris. Parfait, parfait. Ils se sont compris. They understood each other. Très bien, très bien. Ça, ça marche. Oui, 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 oui. So now, okay. So what I don't exactly French being... Ah. Okay, so maybe this lesson today is not that easy. But stay with us. It's still interesting. So what we've seen so far is the, and that was no problem for most of you, as I could see, because you gave me some really cool examples of verbs. Big family, verbes pronominaux. Sub-family, les réfléchis et les réciproques. Yeah. And now we've seen how come sometimes I have to, when I'm in passé composé, je dois accorder mon participe passé, and sometimes I don't have to. We've seen why. Est-ce que c'est un verbe avec ou sans préposition, basically? Est-ce que c'est un verbe followed by un complément d'objet direct or not? Is it direct or not? That's the little trick to it. Donc, on a vu l'exemple de rencontrer quelqu'un, but téléphoner à quelqu'un, sourire à quelqu'un. Yeah? Okay. And then, another very, very important part of this lesson before we just go for some examples and chat using pronominals, because that's the best way to review and to learn them. I would like to let you know about les pronominaux, qui sont invariables au passé composé always. Super difficult, I realized, because these are mistakes you can read every day, but like, mistakes made by French people, like completely, and even when you hear it, I'm sure we make the mistakes sometimes, I'm completely sure. But no, there are some pronominals that are completely invariable, that do not change, au passé composé. I will give you a little list of these verbs, and we'll go through some sentences. And I would strongly advise, if you have a little notebook, I would definitely write them down. It's not useless, really. I would do it. So I'll give you a little list of them, yeah? And then we will write some sentences. Write some sentences with these verbs, pronominaux, au passé composé, because we need le participe passé. Donc, se faire... Se permettre, this one is nice too. Se sourire, we've seen this one before. Se téléphoner, I don't need to give you... Ah, this one. This one is very good because we use it a lot. It's very, very common. This one and this one would be already nice. It's not, it's not a full list, but... Well. Se faire se permettre, se faire mal, se rendre compte, se mentir. Fine, it's already good because we can already write quite a few examples with these. Again, in passé composé, because the point is that these have like the participe passé invariable, and that lots of people, French people, are making the mistake. So it's always interesting. This one. Se faire, se permettre, se faire mal, like to hurt yourself or to, yeah. Se rendre compte, se mentir. Writing some sentences. Ah, we have a very interesting question here. Wait. And we have an answer. Can you explain? You know, in very simple words, could you explain why indeed this is the one? Bonjour à tous, nos âmes se sont parlé et nos âmes se sont parlé. Very tempting to go for the AES. Very tempting. Why is it not correct? It's good that you ask this now because potentially we have the answer. So Mauro could answer, Mary could answer, Manfred could explain because... Ah, I think you cut your answer in the middle. Did you? I think you're explaining, no? It's a very good question here. It's a perfect example, actually. Exactement. Exactement. That's the answer. Parce que parler, precisely, you don't say parler quelqu'un, you say parler à quelqu'un. Yeah. So that's why it has no direct object. Yeah, absolutely. C'est ça. C'est ça. Parce qu'on parle à quelqu'un. OK, now we've got the full explanation. Very good. Very good. That's the reason why. So even though it may be very tempting to be like, OK, so that's a pronominal and être. So obviously, I just go for EES. Kind of tricky here. Kind of tricky here. And I insist. I really insist. I'm pretty sure I ask some people, like French people, and they'll be like, yeah, I think I know how it works. You don't, but fine. Now you do. Parler à quelqu'un, très bien, Mary. Très bien, Mauro. Parfait, Manfred. OK, should we keep going then with the verb, this one? It's the same. It's the same when you write a sentence, you could be tempted. For example, I've heard already, what was it? Elles se sont permises un commentaire désobligeant. But that's weird, no? I'm just no, because I'm just thinking, what's the reason why we cannot use this one? This one is just se permettre quelque chose is perfectly fine. On peut avoir un COD et pourtant on n'a pas le droit de dire elles se sont permises. Si elles se sont permises quelque chose, elles se sont permises. Why is this one working this way? Nous nous sommes permis. You see, honestly, I'm confused myself, parce qu'on peut se permettre quelque chose. Ah, I'm happy. I'm happy, but look at me being confused now with the one I gave you, like, se permettre. What's wrong with this one? Wait, it's in my list for some reason, and I can't even explain myself why. Let's see. Ah, because I think it's se permettre de faire quelque chose. But you can also, elle s'est permise quoi? Elle s'est permise de faire quoi? This one is horrible because it can be both, non? Direct and indirect. Okay, that's not a nice example. I'm sorry for se permettre. Can we forget about se permettre? Se parler est très important. And we've had this example. Se téléphoner est très important. That's the thing. Exactly. I was suddenly super confused, and it's like, why are we not? Yeah. But constantly, like what you're saying here, it's true. It's true. It's like, huh? Why is this one on my list now? I'm making the mistake. Anyways, mais on va trouver un exemple où je peux justifier que se permettre soit dans ma liste. Peut-être parce qu'on pourrait dire se permettre de faire quelque chose. Elles se sont permis de. Ah oui, voilà. Elles se sont permis de dire. Elles se sont permises de dire. I would honestly make the mistake. Here, I was laughing at French people a minute ago saying, and they wouldn't even know how to. I'm confused myself, but probably because there is a de. Look, je me suis permis un chocolat de temps en temps. Yeah, but if it's me speaking, Mauro, can I say je me suis permis un chocolat? Or can I not say that? Je me suis permise de faire quelque chose would be from what I explained to you completely wrong. And I can tell. I said that in my life, and I'm a teacher, which is, you see, like what Mary says. It happens, you trick yourself sometimes. Okay, can we leave se permettre on one side and talk about it later and go back to se faire? Se faire est vraiment, vraiment pareil, hein? Ça, c'est. But this one I know. This one I know that you cannot make the mistake, like je me suis faite. Or something like that, which is so tempting. So tempting. But you cannot do it. For example, this will find some examples because I think I have a full lesson on that. So on this I know. But you see, se faire, for example, Same. My explanation with if you need how to use article in French. Sorry, I'm just seeing a comment here. I'm not sure what you articles in French, I think you mean. Okay. Which is not the topic of the day, but it's fine. Hello, Ute. Hello. A bit of French, a bit of verbe pronominal today. Mm-mm. Yeah, very high level. So high that I'm getting confused myself. Not good. Not good. Se faire, ma liste, se faire, se parler. This one is good. Se permettre, I was confused. Se plaire, se sourire, se téléphoner. Now the rest is all good. Se rendre compte, se faire mal, se faire peur. Ça, c'est parfait. Je me suis... Non. Non. I wouldn't mind a sentence with se faire, actually. And I even remember, look at me. I even remember why se faire is always with IT, and that's it. It's because there is an infinitive after this one. So, je me suis fait prendre en photo. Je me suis fait voler mon téléphone. Je me suis... Well, it works with il. Nous. Nous nous sommes fait... And you would always keep A-I-T. Because usually, after... Well, not usually. Can you do it any other way? After je me suis fait ou il s'est fait, nous nous sommes fait, that would be an infinitive. The fact that there is an infinitive after makes the participe passé invariable. Another rule, just like that, just like that. Yeah, we'd say high level. Can you see that? But they're not lost. There are even more and more people coming, so apparently they like that. They like the confusing part of the verb pronominal. I'm very happy. Okay, more examples. I have to let you write the examples. I'm more confused than you. Se faire. Se faire peur. Se rendre compte. Se rendre compte is also very important. Se rendre compte. Se faire mal. To hurt yourself. Yeah? Same. You wouldn't... These are just... Ils sont invariables parce qu'ils sont invariables. You need to know that. Come on. Let's go through these one and then we'll go for some more... More sentences. We'll go through the vocab we've been maybe reviewing or learning today together, and we'll make some sentences. But first, a bit more with the ones that are completely invariable, so you get used to them. It means that you had something, that someone stole something from you. Yeah, that you were robbed, basically. Mm-hmm. Je me suis fait voler mon téléphone mean I got robbed. I guess you say it like that in English, no? Or my phone was stolen. Yeah. D'accord. Oui, ça, c'est un excellent exemple aussi. Hein. En fait, there are a million things. Now I'm just like completely refreshing. And for example, in that case, je me suis cassé la main. It's a bit like ils se sont lavé les mains. The fact that there is COD. You know, it's not like ils se sont lavés. Ils se sont lavés is one thing. Ils se sont lavé les mains. The fact that there is a COD means that you're not allowed to change laver. Laver has to stay with E, and that's it. It's so many little rules. That's why I told you before, I'm talking a bit randomly, even though I had a full structure, but now I realize that, can you see that? Here it is. Every time I want to show you my notes, I break things. Anyway, but now we're going a bit out of track, but it's a lot of little rules that you need to really write down, because this verb pronominal, that's why I thought I definitely have to do a lesson again on verb pronominal, because you could ask me a million questions, all fair, all full of little, how do we say, like exceptions, which kills another exception and that destroy the rule I just gave you. And, you know, like French grammar, But I think it's very interesting, and that's why I really think soon you will have a brand new lesson on verb pronominaux with all the explanation, examples, and exceptions, and that's it. And then you will have it very clear. Even though you don't seem lost at all, you're perfectly fine. But well done, man, really. Can I say, je me suis cassé ma main? It's not necessary, because we already have the je me suis. Yeah? So obviously, you wouldn't say, je me suis cassé ta main. That's why it makes no sense to put some kind of possessive here. There's no need. Je me suis cassé la main. We know that the hand is yours. You know what I mean? So that's a bit redondant. Je me suis cassé ma main. Yeah? Je me suis fait mal à ma tête. No need. It's actually a very, could be a childish way of talking. Maybe kids make this mistake sometimes. And it's fair. They want to insist on the fact that, but actually, grammatically speaking, it's not needed. Okay, we have two interesting questions here. So as always, I'm calling you people. Here, someone is confused with se rendre compte. Fair enough. Can we explain what it means and write a sentence in present simple and également au passé composé? Très intéressant, le passé composé pour le participe passé that we are going to use. Yeah? So please explain what it means, if you can, with your own words, and give a couple of examples so we can help and clarify doubts here. And then we will answer this question. It's a good question, but yeah. Oui, oui, oui. Oui, oui, tout à fait. Il faut que je me refasse la main sur ce problème. Mm-hmm. You could say that, absolutely. C'est bien. Alors là, s'il te plaît, Mauro, tu te refais la main sur se rendre compte. And you help your partner to understand what it means. Yeah, can you help with that? Se rendre compte. Meaning, sentence, présent, passé composé. And then we will answer the comments right below this one. Because it's a good question, yeah. D'accord. That's a very direct way of saying it, but it is. We could have tried to explain in French, but I think it's good to sometimes just go for the... Indeed, se rendre compte means to realize. Mm-hmm. So examples now. Lenny, I want an example, please. Se rendre compte, Lenny, sorry, I was reading Mary's comments. Se rendre compte de quelque chose, which explains the reason why we will have un participe passé invariable. Sorry, a bit of light, please. Yes, thanks. Okay. Se rendre compte de quelque chose. Très bonne question, Lenny. On a ici une préposition. Mary is... Alicia, in the video, you said you wouldn't scare us with the passé composé form of se rendre. Okay, yeah, no, I don't want to scare you at all. J'étais dans le bus et Okay. Can someone actually, it's good, man. It's the kind of exercises that we do on the app. Like you have to complete the sentence with the correct form. So j'étais dans le bus, I was on the bus, et I realized that I've, you know how to say that in French, Mary. Why is that bit in English? Can you say that in French now? J'étais dans le bus et je, and then? And Mauro says, je pense que c'est comme I realized that. Je me suis rendu compte que j'étais en retard. C'est bien, Mauro. This sentence work. Yes. Je me suis rendu compte qu'il pleut. Alors, you can also put it, it's good because you are putting it in passé composé, which is great. You can also keep it in present simple. In that case, Andy, for example, you could perfectly say, je me rends compte qu'il pleut dehors. Like, because you're realizing now. Je me rends compte qu'il pleut dehors. Yeah? Mary's trying. Je me suis rendu. Exactly. Exactly. Je me suis rendu compte que. What was. That I forgot my keys at home. Okay. Je me suis rendu compte que. Maybe the last part of this sentence may be a little bit difficult because you would need like un plus que parfait. Because actually it would be like that I had forgotten my keys at home. No? I was on the bus when I realized that I had forgotten, that I had left my keys at home. J'étais dans le bus et je me suis rendu compte. Ah! No, the end of the sentence is not correct. The beginning is good. The beginning is good. Uh-huh. Let's see if we can finish this sentence. Ooh, Mary, she made it complicated. Let's see. Se rendre compte, and then I want a sentence with... Ah no, first we had to answer a question that we had before. Let's see. Je suis confus avec se rendre compte. So we are on it now. And then we will answer, yeah. Someone can finish this sentence, otherwise I will help. I will ask you a second. I'll be right back. New comments. Let's see. Have we solved the mystery? J'avais oublié les clés à la maison, chez moi. J'avais oublié mes clés chez moi. Good. Good. Mystery solved. Yes, c'est ça. La phrase serait, j'étais dans le bus et je me suis rendu compte que... I would put a... Moi, je mettrais un plus que parfait. Hein. J'étais dans le bus et je me suis rendu compte que j'avais oublié mes clés à la maison. Yeah, the action was even happening before. I was on the bus, but there's something that happened before. Is that I had forgotten or left my keys at home. Donc, j'étais dans le bus quand ou et je me suis rendu compte que j'avais oublié mes clés, les clés à la maison. Well done. Les clés de ma maison, yeah. J'avais oublié les clés de ma maison. Les clés de chez moi, ça marche aussi. Ou que j'avais oublié les clés chez moi. Works too. Everything works here. It's very good. Very good. So this is solved. We had one more question. I'm confused. Here. Someone's asking, how come we say je me suis dit and we don't say je m'ai dit? Fair enough. So how come? Why do I have to say je me suis dit and not je m'ai dit? Eh bien oui! Thanks! Thanks! We were losing like viewers, but it's not my fault. I wait. I asked a simple question. Thank you. Exactement. Les verbes pronominaux, we've got a perfect answer. Yes. Parfait. We've got the English version. Verbes pronominaux utilisés avec être. Parce que c'est un verbe réfléchi. That's also a good answer. Parce que se dire est un verbe pronominal. Absolument. Because pronominal is used with être. Super. Very proud of you. So that was the answer to our student question. Thank you very much for this question anyway. And now we're going to do just a sentence with this one and then check some vocab and everything. I have one more thing to tell you about pronominals, actually. One structure that we use in some kind of impersonal way. You will understand very quickly what I mean by that when I give you the example. And what I told you before, the pronominals by nature, the one you need to know, but you can't really say, oh, of course, it's pronominal because these verbs refer to an action I'm doing to myself or to a mutual action with someone else. Sometimes it's just, look, this verb is like, it's pronominal. That's it. There is no grammatical reason. Yeah. So we have these two things to do. But first, please, a sentence or two. Maybe three with se faire mal. Ideally, I would like these sentences in plural and in passé composé. Again, just to see and to remember. Yes, it's correct. And to remember that your participe passé will stay the same always. Yeah? So let's have a look at that. Se faire mal, a couple of sentences, plural, passé composé. And then I give you two more little things that I would like you to know about the les pronominaux. And then I check your vocab. Is it sound to say oublier quelque chose quelque part? Yeah, that's a mistake actually that I very often say, like that I often do in this is a mistake that I actually often make. No, I make a mistake when I say, oh, and I forgot this, and it's like, exactly, I left my keys at home, or oh, I left my glasses in the restaurant. But I mean, you can say that, j'ai laissé mon téléphone à la maison, but it looks like you did it because you wanted to. Je l'ai laissé. I left it there because I wanted to leave it here. But if you say j'ai oublié, then I understand that it stayed there, but you actually wanted to take it with you. So no, it's not exactly the same logic. But I know that in English, it's sometimes much better to say I left my keys at home, or and forget doesn't really work for some reason. So yeah. Very happy to read that. Ah, on a des super phrases là. On a des super phrases. Là, ils se sont fait mal en faisant féminine. Féminine. En faisant de la randonnée. Une randonnée. If it was just like one precise day where they went on a randonnée. Donc, ils se sont fait mal en faisant de la randonnée, en faisant une randonnée, en faisant des randonnées. Yeah. Parfait. Fait. FIT. C'est génial. Ici, on a encore une forme au pluriel qui marche très bien. Ils se sont fait mal en montant l'escalier. Ils se sont fait FAIT. Ça, c'est génial. Et je, alors, it works also with je, of course. Hein. Je me suis fait mal au genou en jouant au foot. On joue au foot. Très bonne phrase également. Très bonne phrase. OK. Javier has a question. Very kind of you. Very kind of you. And you would like to have a video. Look, I'm taking you very seriously. What would you like? Ne que et seulement. Il n'y a que cinq personnes. Il y a... D'accord. D'accord. So, ne que. And seulement, you would like some examples and just the meaning of it. And can I use both all the time? Or is it sometimes I can use one more than another? And yeah, it's always very interesting to have videos on that. So I guess that would be probably an A2 lesson. And we can totally think about it. Yeah, sure. Ça marche. Alors, je ne comprends pas trop la phrase « je me suis mal aux cheveux ». Je me suis… Je... Ah, but just because the face missing. Je me suis fait mal aux cheveux. Because maybe you are trapped somewhere. You trap them while closing the door. Je me suis fait mal aux cheveux. Yes, yes. I accept this sentence. Absolutely. C'est pas mal. Donc, se faire mal. To hurt oneself. And important to remember that you would always keep the fait, F-A-I-T, even if it's plural. Yeah? What else? Alors, il y avait une autre chose. If I say... Je peux écrire une phrase comme les gens... porte beaucoup cette couleur en été, for example. Mauro, for what you ask now, honestly, I would say, because it's, well, elle sait, S apostrophe, non? Elle sait, S apostrophe, E-S-T, elle s'est mordu quoi la langue? C-O-D, donc c'est un peu comme elle sait laver les mains. Laver has to stay with the E. Elle s'est mordu la langue. I say U. If there is an exception to the exception of the exception that I said before, I die. To me, elle s'est mordu U la langue. If you just say elle s'est mordu, she was nervous, elle s'est mordu, and you don't say what, then probably you can have a final E. The fact that you say what, that's it. On enlève l'accord. L'accord du participe passé. That's my take on it. Les gens portent beaucoup cette couleur en été. Bon, en hiver. So I don't have like the stress that I cannot even write. Les gens portent beaucoup cette couleur en hiver. An option could be on porte un on, c'est très général. On porte beaucoup. Cette couleur en hiver. And in that case, you could also use the structure. Cette couleur se porte beaucoup en hiver. Do you understand like how it works? Les gens portent beaucoup cette couleur en hiver. On porte beaucoup cette couleur en hiver. And then we don't even really talk about the subject and we just say... We put the importance on cette couleur and we say cette couleur se porte, pronominal, se porte beaucoup en hiver. That's another way of using a pronominal and in that case, of course, on n'est pas sur un pronominal réfléchi, on n'est pas non plus sur un pronominal réciproque, on est sur un pronominal that we use a bit like an expression or way of expressing general... Yeah, exactly. Spanish would work the same. Absolutely. Yeah, it's true. So for you, no problem to understand that, I guess. But cette couleur se porte beaucoup en hiver. Or I had the example of ce vin, or whatever it is. Ce vin se boit bien frais. Yeah. Voilà, donc là, encore une fois, c'est un pronominal, mais c'est un pronominal plus pour parler de on. On, les gens, en général, and we say, ce bon. Si, si, c'est habla espagnol, claro, claro. Yeah, yeah. Igual un día lo hago así, no, nada de inglés, y todo en castellano y francés. Podría ser una opción. Okay, so that works. And the last one, because this one, yeah, not much more to say. It's just that I wanted you to know that you could have this kind of... Et beaucoup de phrases peuvent se transformer comme ça avec un pronominal. Do you want to give me an example? But Manfred, because it's so close to the Spanish structure, can you give me a sentence of your own avec avec ce to talk about people do that in general, but we don't put the emphasis on the subject. Do you think you can find a sentence, a cool sentence for us? But you see, for example, this sentence you gave, se habla español. This one we couldn't translate, no? In French at all. It wouldn't work. Ah, yes, Mary, yes. Yeah, absolutely. Ce film se regarde très bien. Well, you leave it like that, or it could be ce film se regarde très bien en famille, ou se regarde très bien pendant les vacances de Noël, because it's nice, the topic is about Christmas, for example. Yeah. Yeah, non. I knew you would say that, Manfred. So you see, it's not exactly like in Spanish in the end. It's not exactly the same. Because this se habla español en francés sería on parle français. Non? Se come muy bien en este restaurante. On mange très bien dans ce restaurant. Yeah. So it's not exactly the same, actually. It's not exactly the same. Let's see if we can find one. I wonder now if it's the same expression than in Spanish, but sí, porque podrías decir, se lleva mucho este color en invierno. Se lleva mucho este color. Este color se lleva muy bien en invierno. Cette couleur se porte très bien en hiver. But in some other situation, it doesn't work. But yeah. So Mary found a sentence. And not that easy, huh? We thought it would be, yeah, you get it, no? So, no sé, one that we could translate from Spanish could be. Por ejemplo, se practica mucho. It's more nuanced in French. Absolutely. I had one in Spanish that could be translated in French, but into French. But anyway, bah, we got the idea and we know that it's not exactly like in Spanish. Yeah. Because some of the se habla, se hace, océan is sometimes translated by on in French and sometimes it's actually translated by ce. Yeah. Here you would say, bien se comporter est la règle d'or. Bon, ou la règle. I don't know why I said the, but it would be, I don't know, I had the feeling. C'est la règle d'or. La règle d'or est de bien se comporter. Wow! It started to rain all of a sudden, like quite intense. OK. Voilà, donc ça c'était pour cette couleur se porte beaucoup. Voilà, ce livre se vend très bien. Yeah. C'est-à-dire qu'on vend bien ce livre en ce moment. We could have an on formule, like on vend bien ce livre en ce moment. On vend beaucoup ce livre en ce moment. And then if we put the emphasis sur le livre, you would say le livre se vend très bien. Absolutely. Yes. And then I just need to look for the list of the famous pronominals by nature, because I think they're interesting. I mean, maybe you want to have a couple written down. It's not a. You'll tell me, but I don't think it's only super common verbs. Some are very informal, some are. I will show you. If I find the list again, but I'm sure I have it somewhere. La, 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 la. Here it is. S'évanouir, s'en aller, s'extasier, We'll write, as always, not five of them, and then maybe we can try to do some sentences. Maybe it's some new vocabulary. Do you know all of them? I will send them right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. I could give you the full list, actually. It's quite big, huh? So votre autre yeah. Okay. Do you know all of them? Say, I will read them loud. S'évanouir, s'en aller. S'exclamer, se marrer, informel mais très commun. It's good if you know this one. S'enfuir, s'envoler. So these, yeah, exactly. They're just pronominal because they're pronominal. They completely don't respect the rules I gave you before. They just happen to be pronominal. It would be nice to have some sentences with this one to finish the lesson. And it would be nice if some of these verbs you didn't know. So maybe we even, maybe we have some new vocab. Pourquoi se prononcer? Mais la prononciation est faite par nous. Se prononcer, in that case, you know what it means, non? Je ne me prononce pas sur ce sujet, non? I don't want to express myself on this topic. Se prononcer. Tu peux prononcer quelque chose, mais l'expression « je ne me prononce pas » is like « I don't give my personal opinion ». It's that's exactly what it means. Like je ne me suis pas prononcé sur ce sujet. I didn't give any personal input on this matter. Yeah. Ah cool. You don't know any of them. Cool. Okay. I'm gonna call Manfred and Mauro maybe, and Lenny. Lenny is here. So je m'en vais absolument. Let's see, in passé composé. Oh, it's not that easy because of the on and everything. Not that easy, this one actually. Like he left. S'en aller, Mary, to leave. S'en aller, je m'en vais. Il s'en va. Nous nous en allons. To shed light, really? Yeah, shed light is something a bit... Okay, yeah. Se prononcer, to shed light on something. Okay. Is that the only definition you found for se prononcer? Like, je ne me prononce pas sur ce sujet? It's not really that I don't want to shed light on something. It's just that I don't want to give my opinion. I'll go back to the verb I gave before. So we had s'évanouir. Mary is the example. The example we have here. Yeah. Even though the sentence, je me suis évanoui. Je me suis évanoui. Après 4 bières. Mary, what could that mean? Yeah, on y va, allons-y. Yeah, you know the structure with the Y, but we also have la structure avec en. Je m'en vais. But you could say j'y vais or je m'en vais. I leave. Je m'en vais. J'y vais. Elle s'en va. Where is she going? Elle s'en va. She's leaving. Yeah, it's good to know this one too, yeah. Je m'en vais, tu t'en vas, il s'en va. And how would you translate the évanouir thing? Like, je me suis évanoui après 4 bières. Why not? Or you could say, je me suis évanoui quand ma star préférée, mon acteur préféré m'a parlé. Yeah, and because of all these emotions, tu t'es évanoui. What could it mean? S'évanouir? Andy, yeah, you... Tomber dans les pommes, exactly. Exactly. It means tomber dans les pommes. Yeah, absolument. S'évanouir, c'est tomber dans les pommes. Bien, bien, bien. So you've got it. And you've got even the super expression. Yeah. Yeah. Or what is it? To pass out? Something like that? Ça, ça marche. Donc, s'évanouir, c'est bon. S'en aller. Ciao. S'exclamer. S'exclamer. Do you have the same word in... I need the guys here. S'exclamer. How do we say in English? S'exclamer de quelque chose. Il s'est exclamé. Oh, regarde! Ils sont là! S'exclamer, donc, avec un point d'exclamation. S'exclamer. How do you say that? Ah, okay. Same, right? Sometimes I just look for complication. There is no complication. D'accord. Ok. Maybe a quick sentence avec s'exclamer? D'accord. C'est la même chose. Après, on peut s'exclamer de beaucoup de choses. Hein. Ça peut être positif ou négatif. Il s'est exclamé, et vous allez dire, non, je n'irai pas. Ben, c'est s'exclamer, non? Ou au contraire, s'exclamer, oh, mais c'est fantastique. Vous vous êtes exclamé de quelque chose. OK, exclaimed. You have it. So let's check the other one. Wait. Where are my verbs? S'évanouir, s'en aller, s'exclamer, se marrer. Se marrer is very nice, informal. I think we may even finish with this one. The other one, s'enfuir, to run away, s'envoler, to fly away. Okay? It comes from voler, s'envoler. Yeah? S'enfuir, to run away. But se marrer, ah, je me suis exclamée. Absolument, absolument. Et se marrer, we'll finish with a couple of sentences with se marrer, which means just to, yeah, exactly. Do you know what it means? I'm not going to say anything. Just give it a try. Try to use it in a sentence. I tell you if it's cool. Et s'envoler, yeah, to fly away. Absolutely. Uh-huh. Une phrase avec se marrer. Come on, it would be nice to finish with this. I think it's a nice expression. It's a B1 informal expression. It's cool. It's cool to finish the live with that. Se marrer, pronominal, just because it's a pronominal. And ils s'en est allés, ils s'en sont allés. Yeah. Hmm. C'est pour ça, Mauro, vu que tu vois, ça donne un côté un peu formel. Genre, il est où? Il s'en est allé. You understand why we would use more spontaneously il est parti, même si il s'en est allé est une très jolie formule, mais c'est un petit peu s'exclamer il, ok, right, Sorry, I was just reading the sentence below that. Ils s'en est allés, ils s'en sont allés. Absolument, Mauro. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Et finalement, c'est du joli français comme ça, but it's not very used, maybe. Maybe more written. Elle s'en est allée. Elle est partie. More spontaneous, I'd say. Can you write a sentence with se marrer? Because it would be classy to finish my life with a nice sentence with se marrer. Please. Otherwise, I will have to write it, but it's not the point. Yeah. You have 3 minutes. Ah! Thanks, Andy. Alors, autocorrection, Andy. You can do it. Autocorrection. Nous se marrons avec nos amis. Oui, first autocorrection, avec. Nice. Second. No, not the same. This means you're completely fed up. But no, nous nous marrons is much more positive. It's to have a laugh, to have some fun, to, I don't know the informal expression in English to say, on se marre. We are, I don't know, having a blast. I don't know. On se marre. So, nous nous se marrons avec nos amis. Correction. Oh, Mauro, elle se marre pour un rien. I love it. Very nice. Very nice. They just laugh for anything. Yeah, I mean, se, yeah, elle se marre. Yes, because se is the, c'est le pronom réfléchi qu'on utilise avec il, elle, singular or plural. But Andy decided to make a sentence with nous. So it's true. Mauro saved us with a cool sentence with Mauro. It's true. Mary's right. I really wanted this sentence, you see? And it was like, okay, Alicia, here you go. Nous. But no one corrected this sentence. I can't leave until this is corrected. I'm not gonna feel fine. Nous se marrons avec nos amis. No. Because we have two pronoms réfléchis in this sentence. Why? This works too, Lenny. Hein? C'est bien. Elle se marre. It's only ladies having fun. Elle se marre à cause d'une blague. Yes, of course. Of course. Uh-huh. Ah! Bah, merci. 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 Nice. You're kind to me. You're really kind. Okay. Il se marre avec son ami. I really love this expression, really. Se marrer? I love it. I love it. I think that it really reflects the idea of fun. Il se marre. It's really nice. Okay. Nous nous marrons avec nos amis. Très bien. Très bien. Oh, but it's corrected everywhere. It looks fantastic. Look who's coming when I'm going to say goodbye. Is that even possible? Guys, before you leave, first, thank you. Second, it was not an easy lesson. A to B one, huh? This one, even though maybe it sounded all a bit, but there was nothing difficult about it. Yes, yes, there were some important things we had to clarify. Third, I had a good time as always, but this you know. Mauro is becoming more and more fluent and informal, is ready for Paris, for the tough Paris. Yeah, but Momo, I mean 4:30, it's exactly when I have to leave. What happened? Where were you? And next thing, I think I see you. I don't think, I'm pretty sure. I see you this time, not in 2, but in 3 weeks. That takes us to the 11th of May. And it will be, again, if I'm not lying to you, a very special. I think it's going to be a big hasta luego, Manfred. Muchísimas gracias. It's going to be a very, how do you call that? The mashup. Yeah, so we're going to be all together from the different channel. And hopefully we'll have a lot of fun. And you guys will be here asking questions, playing games with us. and that's it. So yeah, you have a bit of how can I say that? Time off, time out. Yeah, you won't have to put up with my live stream for a little bit. But I hope the exams went well, Momo. And I see you in May, 11th of May, for a special. And I'm super happy if you learned a little bit today. If you have any question even afterwards that you want to leave, you know, in the comments, like, hey, Alicia, by the way, forgot to ask during the live, but this and this and that. More than happy to read you, to answer you and everything. And as I told you before, I think we'll have a very special lesson on verbe pronominal. It's worth it. Merci Mauro, merci beaucoup à tous. It's always super nice. Et à très très vite. Take good care of you. Bye bye.